All right, so when I was yesterday, I was getting so many mails, these emails of this democracy now and all of this, you know, join our party and all of that. And I'm like, well, no, because right now I see democracy as the democratic group and this republican group, this, what do they call it, Republic of Americas or whatever. It's just not working. I just see it as a fight, a constant fight with each other. And because of this is not working, how to fix it, you know, how to fix it, because I can't just say, like I said, I just don't think it's working. That's what I told them. I don't want to join you because I don't believe it's the, what do we call it, the independence of the United States, that big document they wrote. I don't believe that it's working for everybody. I think it's become a mess. So, yeah, well, just one side starts making the rules when they're in power, and then the other side gets to make a few rules when they're in power, you know. So it just seems to be like this, and then they take the old rules away. So no, it's kind of like childish right now. It's like a childish government. So I'm like, well, how can we just like come to terms with the fact that we have so few voters, that so few participants in this governmental United States and Europe, for that matter, all over the place. We have a lot of that don't participate nor care. They just pay their taxes, and that's that. So how to change the government, you know, make a voter class. And when I say a voter class, I don't mean that has anything to do with your material wealth, but perhaps that is your part of your identification of who you are. You are a voter that is a participant in the current state of government as it ebbs and flows on a daily basis. I mean, because here I am, I'm out here, I'm looking at these votes that are headed through, and you know, you can have 30, 40, 50 votes some days, or you can have, you know, 10 or 20, depending on who you are, how you want to modify it for yourself. But, or you know, just 10 votes a week, I know it, you can just sign up to one. But the fact that you would even be there signing up, or be even current in making the voting process, being part of the petitioners, that is the alive state of government. That is the alive moment. And those are the real people. You know, they talk about this, we the people of the United States of America. Well, the real people are the ones that are on a daily basis that they're saying, yes, that is a good idea. No, that is not a good idea. You know, they're the ones out there saying yes, and they're saying no. And those people are a voter class. Okay. Now, this voter class has to somehow fit in. We have to fit them into the current documentation that is here for this United States, or the current documentation that is there in Europe for the socialist states. We have got to fit in the voters. So it is not just the elect few. So it is not just us yelling, impeach Trump, you know, and then now all I see in my dream is Trump running around with a peach, with his face in a peach, you know. I mean, that doesn't do anything for us. It's just become a madness machine yelling, impeach Trump. So no, I mean, I really believe we need to, we have the Supreme Court, right, okay, the judiciary, we have the legislative branch, We have the executive branch. Okay, so we now need to add this fourth branch, and I know I hate to say it, add a branch, that sounds horrible, but right now I don't believe I can kick out the executive and the legislative and just be pure voter class. Unfortunately, I don't believe so. We need the judiciary, and we need this voter class. So I'm saying is add a fourth branch to the tree. And the voter class would be treated just as a daily basis. You know, it's coming in, and I'm getting it on my machine. You know, how many votes are in on the voters? The voters are saying this way, lean it. The voters are saying that way, lean it. And that is a pure government that is like in the now, I will say, that is in the current. It is not the four-year temper tantrum, why did we vote for him? It is something that is alive, rather than the dead stigmatism of the associated group that were hired. You know, you hired them and you can't fire them, type of thing. They were the associated group that were hired. And so here we have this voter class. And, oh my gosh, they are like the waves of the moment. They are absolutely the waves of the moment. You know, we don't want leather shoes anymore. How about that for a wave? We want shoes that don't kill animals in the making of. How about that for a wave of the moment? So the government is like, well, in our electorate, we have the legislative, we have the judiciary, we have the executive, which is really just an emblematic. He is only ever supposed to be an emblematic diplomat, went around and shook the hands of the other countries of the world, he or she, and was time for tea and scones. That's really all you are. Just that's it. And somehow he's become a superpower over these others. And the judiciary is not flogging him, not giving him a good flogging. So it's gotten out of hand, you understand? But the voter class will make sure that the judiciary is behaving. The voter class will make sure that the legislative branch is behaving. And they will also make sure that that executive power is also a behaving self. So, anyway, so that's my take on democracy and how it will really truly work. Is you have to bring in this voter class, and it doesn't have to be a bunch of people. It can be I said a million. It would be nice to have a pure million that were there all the time, ready to vote. You know, on their days. You know, at least 3 days a week they vote. That would be nice to have that million at your beck and call, just the handful of people, and they run the waves of the government of this United States and of this EU, because life changes so quickly, you know. So anyhoot, yeah, 4 years is a long time, you know. You have to think about when they were writing this Declaration of Independence, you know, they were on the horseback. Yeah, they traveled a lot of places on horseback, we know. But on the horseback, they were on a different time scale. They did not have trains. They did not have the postal mail service on a daily basis like we have. I mean, so the whole agenda, they did not think about how quickly things occur in the future. And it's much faster than their their dogma of, well, we vote him in, and then, you know, they have time to go back to their smoking room and talk about things for another month. And yet things were a lot slower. Now we're in rapid government. So yeah, so the voter class, that's what we need to adopt in, and that's why I am not joining the Democratic Party, because it does not work in its current state.